ChatGPT Agents is here, and I'm really excited about it. Probably it is one of the general purpose AI agents that actually does things for you. And at the same time, being so accessible right within ChatGPT without you needing to pay a premium. So think of it like the ChatGPT operator browser control combined with deep research. But more than that, with everything ChatGPT can do, image generation, scheduling, connectors, projects, you can just turn on agent mode, describe your task, it will set up the virtual environment and run it autonomously. You can see how it is taking action in real time, view the actual activities log to make sure everything is in control. You can also interrupt it at any time by prompting or take over the control for any work guidance or stop it completely. And this unlocks so many possibilities to offload your daily work tasks. And let's start with something every marketer hates, the reporting deck. I'm sure this is definitely what most marketers are thinking about. So let's ask ChatGPT agent to do a simple SEO audit for a brand and have it build an initial deck draft for me. So let's say I'm an SEO consultant and I am preparing an audit performance deck for potential client Ashley Furniture. So turn on agent mode. I will first ask it to pull the high level SEO performance data. And to keep it simple, I will ask it to pull data from spyfood.com, which offers free SEO performance data with a login. And that helped me to run an initial page speed test for this site. And finally, combine all these findings and create a presentation deck for me with the sections that I specified. So it first started searching and then navigate to the spyfood.com and is pulling the data for me from Ashley Furniture. So this is incredible. And it start capturing the key SEO metrics and all the performance data as well as competitor information. So it is already doing the analysis for you. And this is so useful as not all of these data intelligence platforms will provide API connections to draw data from, especially when you have multiple clients or prospects to handle. And now it is following the instructions to run the page speed insights for any technical issues. And it's digging through different diagnosis, performance issues, and even scrolling through both mobiles and desktops. So this is mind-blowing. And now it is generating the slides, generating the images. So that is what makes ChatGPT agents powerful, because basically it can access all the building capabilities of ChatGPT. Like in this case, generating images, building presentations. You can always watch back the screen recordings to understand what the agents have actually done for you. And I would say this is not too bad. Although it is not beautifully designed, it is fully functional with all the key data we have requested. The top line performance, technical performance, keywords, competitors, proposed actions, and you can also share this to your team with a link as well, or just download it for any custom changes. And now another incredible thing is you can set up a schedule by clicking this little clock icon after the agent has completed the task. So it will automatically define the task detail for you with the task name and instruction, and you can always change it. So perhaps you want to run it monthly and it is for a particular client. So this will be useful if you need to prepare a regular performance report for your stakeholders or certain clients. Perhaps you need to pull data from Search Console or any platform, or you can even ask the agent to drop you a summary email for you and schedule to run it regularly. But what about the creative side of marketing, the actual creative research and execution? I know this is something we all struggle with, and even though there's so many AI automation to scale content creation, they do not automate what marketers actually need to do in the real world. Complex visual analysis and research, work involving website with reasoning, it's just not that linear. So we are going to ask the agent to visually analyze content and then complete a content calendar. Let's say our brand is in the home design niche. This time, we also set up a ChatGPT project to make sure the agent can retrieve relevant context about the brand. And we can set up a simple custom instruction stating what this project is about. And here is our brand style guideline with the brand voice, visual identity requirement, target audience. So first, upload this guideline to the project. And here is the Pinterest content calendar on Notion. And we want the agent to create actual content assets which we can use on Pinterest. And we will leverage data from Pinterest Trend, which currently don't have a full API data access available. Now turn on agent mode and ask it to research the latest interior design using Pinterest Trend plan and create a full month of August content with total 4 posts, which are on every Wednesday, and generate Pinterest ready assets along with pin title, description, and hashtag, and upload them back to Notion. Also give it directions how it should do the research, generate the assets, create content together with some important constraint. So it is now searching on Pinterest trend, and I like how it is following my instructions to focus in United States and set the filter and using the keyword home interior design as the seed keyword. Then it is identifying all related trends and topics, and you can see it navigates back and forth, searching with different keywords to try to analyzing the pins, scrolling, and also analyzing the visual style description from the popular pins. So this is quite impressive. And I can see it tried for a few different related popular topics, and now it is compiling the insights, generating the visual assets. And after almost 20 minutes, so it returns to trending insights. What are the potential topics, style tags that those popular pins use, the visual patterns, and use of description. So this is great. And what I really like is the proposed content calendar with all the details on instructor, published date, pin title, to generate an image asset, description, hashtag, and I love this style, so this is perfect. And if you want, you can actually just stop at this step. But let's take a step further and ask it to upload them on Notion. So when you click on the login, it will give you the control to the browser, and you can then log into Notion within the virtual environment. But always be reminded there is a data risk, so use it only when necessary. So now it is continuing the upload process, and this is a very funny process to watch. So you can see it is having issues in pasting the pin title and doing self-correction, deleting and creating again. But it has picked the wrong month, so it should be August 6th on Wednesday. But I understand why, because there is something wrong in the Notion calendar suddenly that the label still shows August, but it's actually July. Anyway, it's still able to complete the whole uploading process. And still, I am very impressed as how it helps to upload all the post details to this Notion calendar with the generated assets, and you can download them as well. So these are really nice visuals, and it's not missing any critical details. And it's not just for content calendar. Maybe you just wanted to collect visual references, research insights, and dump it to Notion on autopilot. So there are lots of related use cases. So ChatGPT Agent just proved it can help us create content assets, manage the content calendar. But here's where it gets really powerful. So while most demo shows agents buying stuff, which feels impractical because these are still high-stakes decisions, I think the killer use case that can create immediate values for growth marketers is actually simulating user journey for UX research that requires advanced reasoning. For example, I'm doing UX research for Warby Parker, so an online prescription glass store, and comparing the user journey with another competitor site, LensCrafter. So we will ask it to act like a customer and go through the whole process from browsing to checkout page and to mark all the key friction points, key highlighted features, and then compile it into a presentation. So this time, instead of the standard building presentation, so we will ask it to do a Google slide presentation. So note, to keep it simple, I will just ask it to stop at the guest checkout page and not to proceed with any sensitive personal information. So it is navigating to the Warby Parker website first before it checks LensCrafter site. And I can see it is navigating different sections and simulating the shopper's behavior. So ChatGPT Agent is testing all the key areas for you, doing product browsing, click products, selecting options, taking notes for each step, just like what we're doing typically for any UX research analysis. And I also see it is trying to overcome some issues encountered in the process, making decisions, and this definitely requires advanced reasoning. So this is absolutely mind-blowing. Although for Warby Parker, the final page after clicking guest checkout can't load successfully for some reasons, we still have documented the entire user journey up to that point. So now it's prompting me to log into Google Slide and start building the slide, adding all together insights, doing self-correction, and I'm especially impressed by how it can insert a table when it's using Google Slide. It's just so satisfying to see how it actually do the things for you. And although in terms of design, it is not that impressive, and I still need to adjust the formatting, but ChatGPT still delivered the job, pulling the side-by-side user journey comparison with key step, friction point analysis, and recommendations. So it definitely saves you lots of time analyzing the website yourself. Because imagine you are not just doing UX research for two websites, maybe 10 websites. The time-saving benefits is huge, and you can always adjust the output. Maybe just ask it to output you as a document using the built-in canvas. So there's still a lot of value. And to make the best use of this, I suggest you to specify more details around the area you want the agent to test. Is it product browsing, search functions, or site navigation? The more detail you give the directions, the much better the analysis. But UX research is qualitative and focused. What about quantitative insights at scale? So here's where ChatGPT agents really shines. It can dig through massive unstructured data like customer reviews, forum discussion, comments, emails, and then turn it into structured insights with trust. So unlike basic web scraping or deep research that just scan text, expensive, the agent can actually browse, click, and make smart decisions about what data matter the most. Let's say I'm a product marketer at monday.com and I want to compare our product against competitor Asana. So here I can ask it to search for all the customer sentiments from forums like Reddit, Quora, LinkedIn, groups, or other open web, and to compile the findings into a Google Sheets with two tables we specify. So one is for the raw data with the columns that we specify, and another tape for the summary with simple charts. So immediately it is setting up the virtual environment and starting the searching process from different sources. Open up browser, and I would say this is so satisfying. And the biggest difference from a typical deep research is that it can perform click, open, scroll actions, and you can always click the activity view to see all the actions it has actually performed, like actually search the Reddit forums, open the feed, and check the comments just like a human. So everything is transparent, and it's a very funny process to see ChatGPT really taking action on Google Sheets for you as well, importing the Getter datasets, and I'm actually impressed that it's trying to apply the condition formatting for the sentiment level, although it's not quite successful at the end. And I noticed ChatGPT agent for now always has some issues clicking on the correct position. And when you see anything abnormal, you can always just prompt it and ask it to fix. Like in this case, I wanted to refine the generated bar charts, and it will correct it for you as long as the section isn't closed. And this is much better with the two separate charts for top pain points and praise. The only complaints I have is the theme categorization is too broad, so making the final generated charts is not that insightful. But still, the agent has completed 90% of the tasks, with the key themes, label the sentiment, the original quotes with source link, and I think this really helps a lot in any data-heavy prep work. So in my second attempt with the predefined key themes, the outcome is even better. And I also asked it to pull more data for me this time. So you can now use it for any kinds of analysis to inform your market messaging, product strategy. So think about what are some unstructured data that will help you to refine your strategy and start from there. And this same research workflows works for any types of tedious business intelligence reporting with the use of building connectors as well, like lead scrolling, where you can pull recent marketing leads from your Gmail account or CRM, have ChatGPT agent research each company background, create priority reports, and schedule weekly lead reviews for you. Besides data analysis like this, content research is another area that agents can help to add massive value. Although there are already so many AI tools, automation to assist the process, in real world, it still requires lots of human involvement, and somehow it still works in silo. So what makes ChatGPT agents so helpful is it can autonomously plan, gather, analyze, and structure information to support your entire content research workflow. For example, I want to start a new YouTube channel about productivity topics, but I don't know where to start for my content strategy. And you know, the best way to do content strategy research is actually on the platform. So in this case, we'll just ask the agent to go to YouTube and search for top channels and analyzing their posting frequency, engagement, and then also dig through the comment sections for audience insight, content ideas, and also validate them using Google Trends and compile as a Google Doc for me. So you can see it is actually searching on YouTube with relevant keywords, browsing different channels, filtering the videos. So this is a bit crazy. And I love how it is smart to use filter options to show just the channel views in order to identify some top channels quickly. And it will also double check using open web data interchangeably. And as he is analyzing the famous YouTuber Ali Abdul's Thomas Frank and scrolling through their videos. So these are all my favorite YouTubers. And you can see it also making its own judgment. Like this productivity guy with just 12 subscribers and 13 videos. It knows it might not be a good reference, and it keeps analyzing all the potential channels and even the comment sessions to study what viewers like. So this is absolutely mind-blowing. And then checking on Google Trends for the topic validation, and then start building the Google Doc for me. Though I would say the final Google Doc is not quite what I have expected with the formatting issues, but the output in the Canvas mode is incredible. So with the executive summaries, all the top channels and the popular topics, the key observations on the content, upload frequency, thumbnails, what their audience pain points, Google Trends analysis, possible content ideas for our new channel, 90 days launch strategy. So this is absolutely fantastic. And of course, always fact checking with your own judgment, but I would say this is a great starting point. And you can even download it as a PDF report. And this is why I like using Agent in this case compared to a standard deep research, is that it will be much more in-depth and it is really doing the research on the platform just like a real human. Clicking buttons, analyzing, making decisions. So this level of complexity is not easily done using any typical AI automation. So when you should use ChatGPT agents, research plus building workflows like pulling competitive data and create presentations. Cross-platform tasks like extracting analytics and cross-reference social performance to make complex decisions. Time-consuming manual work and can't be fully automated, like monthly reporting requiring fresh insights and lots of clicking. Basically, if it requires both thinking, decision-making, and doing across multiple tools, and normally takes you a lot of time, you should consider using agents. But ChatGPT agents is not perfect yet. It can make errors sometimes, having slower speed than you expect, and yes, it might crash and lose connections mid-task. And sometimes more complex multi-step workflow, it can lose context. So for now, stick to low-stake tasks like complex research and data prep. Avoid anything with serious business consequence, like sending client emails or editing important files for you. And also clear your remote browser data regularly in ChatGPT settings to reduce data risk. Join my community if you want to learn how to be more thoughtful of using AI in marketing or online business. You will get access to all the prompts I use in my channel videos, our regular live sections, and all the extra content. You can find the link in the description to join. And before you go, watch this video if you're interested in using ChatGPT for digital marketing. I will see you next time.